Hey, mathematics learners, welcome to Distance Learning with Lee, where I make learning mathematics super easy. So on today's video tutorial, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be looking at, volume as well as surface area. So if you've watched also my video tutorials, you should understand what it means. What are we actually doing when we're calculating volume? What are we actually doing when we're calculating surface area? And just to do a quick recap, right? We spoke about when we're calculating volume, okay, we can think of it in three ways. Okay, or we can view it in three ways. When we're calculating volume, we're just trying to determine how much space, okay, or how much can an object hold, okay? How much can this cup hold? How much water can this cup hold? Obviously, for you to be able to determine how much water that particular cup holds, we need to calculate volume, right? Also, when we're calculating volume, we're also trying to determine if you're thinking of a container, right? You're given a container and you want to determine how much space is actually enclosed within this container. For you to be able to determine how much space is enclosed within that container, you'd have to calculate volume. Sometimes for you to be able to, you need to think of volume in this way, right? For you to be able to determine how much space an object is taking up, okay? How much space is this, tin taking up in this box? We'd have to calculate the volume of that tin, and that will help us determine how much space is this tin taking up in this particular box. Okay, so that is how we're supposed to view volume. Depending on the context, we can look at it in those different ways. If you're trying to determine how much water can this cup hold, when you're calculating volume, obviously we're calculating the capacity. Okay, in some cases we're trying to determine how much space is enclosed within this particular container. Okay, in some context we are trying to determine how much space is this tin taking up in this box. That's how we can view volume. Okay, also we spoke about surface area and how you need to go about calculating surface area of the three your 3D shapes. Okay, if you have to calculate the surface area of a cube, what's very important in those calculations is you being able to understand how many faces does a cube have. Okay, so we know when you're looking at a cube has six faces. Okay, and because we know that a cube, the length of all the sides of the cube are the same, all that we need to do if we have to calculate the surface area of a cube is just that we need to calculate the area of just one of those faces. Okay, we need to calculate the area of, maybe for example, the yellow face. And once we know what the area of the yellow face is, then we know that, I mean, all these faces have the same area. Then we just multiply it by 6. And that just gives us the surface area of this particular cube, right? So when we're looking at surface area, we're not just working in 2D anymore, where we're just looking at just one face. No, but when we're working with surface area, we're looking at, obviously, what is the area at the top, at the bottom, at the front, at the back, at the left or the right face, okay? And we want to add up all those areas together to give us the total surface area of this particular shape, okay? So that's how we calculate surface area. We just want to determine what is the area of all of those faces. You add them up together and that's going to give you the total surface area. Okay, so that's what we're going to be looking at, right? So that's what we're basically going to be looking at in this video tutorial. We're going to be calculating the volume of this cylindrical magic cube, and we're also going to be calculating the surface area of this cubic magic cube. So we're given the dimensions of the cylindrical magic cube. We know that, okay, that is the diameter of the cylinder, right? And we are given the height of the cylinder as 70 millimeters. We are given the length, okay, of, just one side of this, cubic magic cube. And we already know that if it's a cube, all of the lengths of the sides are equal. So that's something that we all need to know. Okay, so it says use the information above to answer the questions that follow. Question 3.1.1 says you need to calculate the radius of the cylindrical magic cube, right? So how do we calculate radius? Okay, if we're given the diameter and you want to determine radius, this is nice and easy. We already know that to calculate radius is just equal to your diameter divided by 2. So we're given that our diameter is 76 millimeters. So that basically means that the radius is equal to 38 millimeters. So that's the radius of our cylindrical cube. Okay, question 3.1.2 asks us to calculate in centimeters cubed the volume of the cylindrical magic cube. Okay, so I'm gonna just take on okay, so how would we calculate the volume in centimeters cubed of the cylindrical magic cube, right? We already know that when you have to calculate the volume of a cylinder, of a prism, we know that with those, we just use the formula of area is equal to, volume is equal to area of the base multiplied by the height. If you're calculating the volume of a cylinder and of prisms, that's the formula that we use, area of the base multiplied by height. Okay, but you don't really have to worry about that because we're actually even given the formula. Okay, so in this case, how do we calculate the volume of a cylinder? We know that to calculate the volume of a cylinder is equal to area of a base, so it's pi r squared multiplied by the height. Okay, so remember in this case, right, we are given the dimensions of this cylindrical cube in millimeters. So all that we need to do in this case, okay, for us to get the volume in centimeters cubed is just convert this value that's in millimeters, or these dimensions that are in millimeters, to centimeters. So how do you convert millimeters to centimeters? Okay, remember, if you already drew these diagrams for yourself, this is supposed to be something that's easy. When you're moving from millimeters to centimeters, you're just going to divide by 10. Okay, so we're just going to take that 76, we want to divide by 10. So if you take 76 millimeters and you divide by 10, this is going to give us 7.6 centimeters. So that is our diameter. Okay, and then if we want to obviously get our height in centimeters, it's still going to be that 70 millimeters divided by 10. So if you divide by 10, it's 7.0 centimeters. Okay, remember we also had to, calculate or determine what is, the radius of our cylindrical cube, right? So here, all that we need to do is we want to obviously determine what is our radius in centimeters. Okay, so to then get your radius, I'm just going to do it here on the side. Okay, so to get our radius, our r, it's just going to be that 38 millimeters, just going to divide by 10, and that's going to give us 3.8 centimeters. Okay, we also found what is our height. Okay, remember I said that our height is just going to be 70 millimeters divided by 10, which is 7.0 centimeters. Okay, from here we really can just calculate the volume of the cylinder. So what is that volume? If your pi, okay, they're giving us that your pi is 3.142, please use the pi that is given. Okay, if they tell you that pi is 3.142, use that pi. Okay, multiplied by what is r squared? Okay, it's 3.8 centimeters all squared, multiplied by what is the height? It's 7.0 centimeters. Okay, if you punch this into your calculator, what are you getting as the volume of the cylinder? Okay, you'll find that the volume of the cylinder, okay, is 317 point, okay, 5.9. Okay, I'm just going to round it off to two decimal places, centimeters cubed. So that is the volume of our cylinder. So that's the space that this cylinder is taking up, or the space that is enclosed within the cylinder. Okay, it's 317.59 centimeters cubed. Okay, let's have a look at question 3.1.3. So it's determine the number of square sides of this cube. Okay, how many square sides or how many faces does this cube have? Okay, so how many faces does this cube have? It has the top and the bottom face, okay, which is what that you can't see. Okay, so if you want to obviously calculate how many faces, or want to determine how many faces this cube has, okay, just also just think of this, right? The top and the bottom, that's two. The left and the right, that's another two. The front and the back, that's another two. So the total faces that this cube has is six. So that's what they mean. Determine the total number of square sides of this cube. This cube has six square faces or sides. Okay, right? So that's that. Okay, the cube has six square sides or faces. Okay, now let's look at question 3.1.4. It says determine or define total surface area. Okay, so what do we mean? What is meant by total surface area in this context? Okay, so obviously we're still working with we're talking about, you know, if we had to find the total surface area of, you know, both the cylindrical magical cube as well as the cubic magical cube, how would you define that? Okay, so when you want to calculate the total surface area, okay, we are just trying to determine what is the sum or what are the total areas of all the faces of the 3D shape. So total surface area is the sum of all the faces or sides of the sum of all the areas. So let's just fix that. The sum of all the areas of the faces or the sides of a 3D shape. Okay. Total surface area is the sum of all the areas of the faces of a 3D shape. Okay. So if we're asking you to get the total surface area, for example, of this magic cube, you'd obviously have to calculate what is the total areas of all of these faces. Okay. Then you add them up together, and that's basically going to give you surface area. Okay. Sometimes remember, okay, don't be deceived. You can be asked a question where you're just given like a, you know, a 2D shape like this, where maybe the length of this 2D shape is equal to 8 centimeters, and the width of this 2D shape is equal to 4 centimeters, and they say to you, calculate the surface area. Okay, we're just calculating the surface, the area of this surface. So it'll be length times width, okay? And if a question is asking you to determine the total surface area and you're working with the 3D shape, that just means that now you want to obviously find out what is the area of all these faces, okay? You want to calculate the area of face number one, two, the front and the back, the side and the side, top and the bottom. Then you want to add them up together, and that's going to give you total surface area, okay? So let's just think of it that way. Don't be confused when they just give you a 2D shape and they say, what is the surface area? They just want the area of this surface, okay? But if they're giving you a 3D shape, obviously, and then they're asking for the total surface areas, okay, then you just want to add up all the areas of all these faces, okay? Well, you want to find out what is the area of one face, that face, this face, that face, add them up together and get to your answer, okay? But sometimes they also give you those formulas, but I would just recommend that you start to know these things off by heart, because when you know these formulas and how these formulas are derived off by heart, okay, you are able to answer it. Even if a question is asking you in this way, you are able to understand what's happening. Okay, so let's just try to move away from, you know, expecting formulas to be given to us. Okay, try to, you know these formulas off by heart. Let them be in you so that when you're answering question, even in whatever situation, you are able to understand what is happening. Even if it's a question where you're calculating, you know, a volume, or for example, a surface area of a cylinder. Okay, but they're telling you that this cylinder, that there's no lid at the top, then you know how to manipulate a formula. Because sometimes they do give you formulas, but now that formula is just a guide. So you need to be able to work with that formula and change it to suit whatever question is being given. So let's try to move away from wanting formulas to be given. Let's start to remember these formulas off by heart. Okay, so we found or we've defined total surface area in this context. Last question. Calculate in millimeters squared the total surface area of the magic cube. You may use this formula. So here, don't be deceived and just think that now you're just supposed to take this formula, area of a square is side times side, and then now you're just gonna take 55 millimeters times 55. No, that formula is just a guide. Now you need to remember, now in this case, right, I have to calculate the surface area of a cube. How do I calculate the surface area of a cube? Okay, how do you calculate the surface area of a cube? So we've already discussed this. Okay, we know that if you're given a cube, right, we know that all the sides or all the lengths of the sides, right, are equal. So here we are given that the length of one side is just equal to 55 millimeters. Okay, so the key when you're trying to obviously calculate the surface area of a cube, it's just calculating because we know all of the areas of all these faces are equal. So all that we need to do, we can just calculate the area of one. Okay, we want to calculate the area of just one face. So if you can get what the area is of just one face, then we're just going to multiply that by six because we know that we've got six faces in total. Okay, or six areas that we are trying to determine the total surface areas of. Okay, so remember, that's the formula of calculating the surface area of a cube. It's six multiplied by area of a square, which is side times side. Okay, so that's how we got to six multiplied by side squared. Okay, that is how we calculate the surface area of a cube. Okay, first calculate the area of one side, okay, or one face. Side squared multiplied by six because we've got six faces. Okay, so in this case, it's going to be six multiplied by what is our side? Sorry, this is actually supposed to be like that. Okay, so it's going to be 55 millimeters all squared. And then what's our answer? It's one. So it's 18,150 millimeters squared. Okay, so that is the total surface area of the magic cube, right? So I hope let's just keep it short and sweet. So that's what we are where we're gonna stop today, right? And I hope you've basically gained from this and just also just the tips on, you know, what is the question is what is the question saying? What is volume? Okay, what is volume? What is surface area? Okay, so I hope you appreciated this video tutorial and I'll see you on my next upload.
That is it, guys, and I'll see you guys on my next upload, Distance Learning with Lee, where I make learning mathematics super easy. Bye, guys.